So her body's been done in a 3/8 or a number 2 comb. Her legs, I went down with a 1-inch comb and then I fluffed them up. And finish your any spaghettis. So I took off her flare because they're going to be going away and don't have someone who can maintain the hair as much, so I took off her main flare that she had. So next onto the head. So normally I will do this area in what the body was in, but reverse. I just will quickly use my blenders because it's easier than me going and switching combs again, especially with the little cowlicks. Now, see how she's so hairy on her face that it can overwhelm her? Because she's quite tiny under all there. So the goal here is to do a short in the brow. We're going to leave a bit of a fringe. Here, I'm going to make this higher. Alright, sorry. Back up, pick her. So to make this fast, I'm going to take a half-inch comb. I'm going to do the strip down the top. Good girl. I don't usually do much of this on her head, so she's a little shy, but I always do everything by hand. So we'll just do this quick to make it fast. So where I'm going is I'm taking from the back here. See that? In the back, but I'm leaving hair to go into the ears. So I'm not taking all that off. Back, and then this little swipe down here. So I'm leaving hair to go in front of the ear. This is just to kind of help set my lines. You can do it all by hand if you want, but my goal is to help people who don't know how to do that. So right there in front of there. If you want, you can clean that up. Sorry, baby girl. Come in. I know. She's so little, she's not comfortable with the clippers, so I usually do a lot of stuff by hand on her. But normally, if they were more comfortable, that's what I would do. I would clean this up just to make it fast. Because this is salon grooming, right? You can shake your head. Just go over there. Now I've switched my clipper to about a 15. I'm just going to clean up by her eye area, so pulling back her bangs. I'm just going to go in really, really light and kind of touch. I don't want a scoop. I don't want a bald spot. And again, this is just a fast salon way to clean up in front of their eyes. Hold your ear. Hold your head up so they got to see. So I'm going to tip her ears and she gets bling on them. I often will switch out my little foot pad and do the 40 on the inside. I'm trying to be fast. We got a busy day. Just because it's a bit neater. There you go. Oh, I drank too much coffee and my hands are shaky. Good girl. You sit down. Good girl. Okay. Now, move your head over here. I'm sorry. So, we're going to lift up this hair here. You can see what I'm doing. Yes, you can. What I'm doing is layering, put your head over there, Susan. I'm layering this area to make it more even. I'm also shortening up the length. And I find this way to make a real nice even finish. Now, if you're good at scissoring, you can just go ahead and go in there with your curves. I'm just setting it with my blenders. You can use chunkers as well. So you could go in and do your blenders, because if you you will get the nicest finish with blenders. If you're very good at scissoring, you can definitely go in, set your line. And then you can go clean up anything. Oops, sorry, making the camera wiggle. I'm sorry, baby girl, but I gotta clean up your lip. So I want to clean up her lip by just taking the bottom. Oh, I'm sorry. Good girl. Keep that tongue in there. And I'm just gonna take... Now I got my thumb underneath and my finger on top, and I actually hold it a bit tighter when I'm actually gonna trim by the lips. because I'm too paranoid to not. So, brushing up and out, we're going to, oh sorry, I keep bumping the camera. I'm gonna layer this down here. See how much smaller that has to be. Boy, you're cuter pants. Okay. Come here, see. I know. I'll turn it so you can see what I'm doing in here. What I'm doing is I'm looking for areas that look heavy. They need layering. They're going to be sticky outies later. Oh, arms are tired. Okay, here. Here's Sadie. So she has a bit of a wave to her hair. That's probably why I've trimmed that top part in the past. I could, ideally, I probably want to let it grow to have weight. I almost don't think her hair would. But it might help hold the straights a bit better. Okay. Either way, I don't really want to trim, unless I'm going to go oval and brush this all up, but hers doesn't stay up. So I think I'm going to try and encourage them. She's part Maltese, so I think I'm going to encourage the Maltese and make it lay down. Okay. But I can't handle that, so I am going to trim it. I just don't think it'll behave itself. Won't behave itself, eh? Alright, now let's finish this side before we move on. So I will layer the back of the ear to help it not have too much weight, make it stand up, but just this very back part, back up to you. So you can do this with a comb, with blenders. I just was being quick and running my clipper on it. I'm going to take the ear itself. Where's your head? Where I've clipped it, I'm going to fold that over. You can do scissors or blenders. With straight coats, you'll get a nicer finish with blenders. And take that same ear again, fold it in half. Now you can do curves. You could do blenders. You can do curves and blenders. Really your choice. Oh, I think my next dog is here. Pause. Okay, I'm back. So, there's that finished, finished ear. Now you can, I did take off the hair down under here. You can take off probably, come here, sweetie. You can probably take off even more. Obviously, I've got a little bit sticking right there. It's ahead of my line. I had some down in here that I removed. And you can kind of play with how it sits. I'm just trying to be fast. All right, let's do your other side. So, layer the back of that ear. This is hard to do on the off side with the camera right there. Let's see what I'm doing. Good girl. So you can see how when you leave it too big, how it's still overpowering to their face. It's very easy to leave it too big. I've been guilty of it myself. Come on, sweetie. This one's been a wiggly one her whole, well, I've only groomed her so long. But. Hey, yeah, you're getting better. Oops, sorry, that's not yours. Let's back you up a little bit, sorry. Good girl, we're gonna. See, now you can totally see what angle I did because I was going over. So I technically probably took off too much there just because of the way I was reaching. Trying to... Dang it. Okay, there's a really perfect example of why you do under. And see, look at the difference. I should have taken from under, but I can't reach. So let's see if I can fix my screw up now. Okay. So this area I'm trimming right here is technically behind the muzzle, in front of the eyes. It's a nice one to layer, just to not have it be so heavy in there. I don't like it to be shaved. I find when it shaves, you know, I gotta take this down to make it match. That, it looks too, I don't know, retro. Too poodle donut poodle, you know, that kind of look. No, I'm actually gonna clean up your throat a little bit. I'm using a blade, but I'm not actually holding it tight. I'm just, as long as she doesn't wiggle too much. We'll still see. I know, you're being very, very good girl. She's a good example because her hair is quite wavy. She's wiggly, and she's scared of, she only gets fluff dried only. So, you know, I can't push that hair. This is about as straight as I can get it. Stay back there. We're gonna move on to your, oops, to your ear. Oh, this is awkward. All right, can you see in there? So again, folding the tip over to set that line. Folding it in half now. I want to make sure that when I fold it in half, I hold it relatively the same as I did the last one, which is a little bit harder with this camera here, but I'm going to try it. So it's too heavy on the bottom. Good girl, sweetie. Come on. Now you can see how where I've cut it shorter is a bit longer in front, so I'm just going to layer that a little bit. You will change that according to the look, how long you leave the fringe, if you want it to actually have that space in front or not. Good girl. I have an edge here. No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean for you to come over here. Good girl. I know. I'll get you a snack in just a minute. Just a minute there, little snack monster. Okay, can we see? Yeah, we can see. So this ear needs to be blended into where the leather is better. This ear needs to be blended into where the leather is better. So that when it's up, it's real hard to figure it out sometimes when they're moving around, right? Or if they won't hold their ears up for you. So, grab a cookie. Oh, I know. Cookie always works. Good girl. So you can see I've got a little bit to fix in front of the left ear. Let's tilt this up. The left ear. I've got a little bit of heaviness on the muzzle. Hi, cutie. My right, her left, but my right, this area is shorter than this area, so I need to shorten that side. Yes, yes, yes. I said you could have it. There you go. Okay. Hey, girl. I know. You only get that one little snack. One little snack. That's it. What a good girl. Oh, I wish I hadn't screwed that up. Hold on. You're pretty whipping cute. See how good your gum holds still for me. Good girl. Oh, good girl. Wait, what's up? Very good example of how, oh, you can't see, sorry. All right, let's put you up again. Don't you steal that cookie, that's for the end. Nope. Nope. That one is the one for the end, you can't have it. You have to wait. Good girl. Good girl. Sorry, I didn't make this high enough again. Sorry, bear with me. I want you guys to be able to see. There we go. Better. The hair to your eye. So, I had shortened up this side because it was not as short as the other side. I layered up in front of the ear. This one could stand a light layer. I have more hair coming from this side than this side. So, I'm not sure if I want that much or not. Well, it's kind of pretty, but I'll have to make it even. That's better. And she has, her hair naturally grows cowlicks up there and down there, so that might be as best as I'm gonna get it. But you can see the difference in how when I use the curve up this way, when I used my curves this way, how much nicer of a circle I get than when I went down. It's almost like it's heavy. Excuse me. A heavy under here. I'm not sure if that's... What a good girl. Anyways, my amount of time that I've allotted for this is kind of done, so we have to... Hey, speaker girl? But... Let's take this all off. What a good girl. I have the cookie stinker. Yeah, I have it. Nope, stay there. Good girl. Wait, hold still. So, yeah, I'm not happy with the muzzle, but I have a hard time with the muzzle. Good girl. Here, you get that. That's what you wanted, isn't it? So, again, go to the side. Turn your head, sweetie. Turn. No. You get a good look at it from the back. All right. There's Roxy. Good girl.